Hello students, this is Zuned, M.M.SHAIKH, taking my first ever video lecture. The topic is from fluid mechanics. I just wanted to take a prerequisite that we were dealing with. The chapter was pipe flow and the topic that was left to do in the class was Hardy cross method. Let's take a prerequisite first of all. What we did was the losses in the pipe. We dealt with the losses in the pipe. There were two types, major and minor. We had solved some problems related to both the losses. Then we dealt with the pipe networks or compound pipes. There were two types, pipes in series, pipes in parallel. We solved many problems related to that topic. And probably the last topic of this chapter is pipe network. The diagram that you can see is a pipe network which is to be analyzed, or in simple words, there are five pipes you can see in the pipe network as AB, BC, CD and AD. We need to find what discharge exactly should be given to each of the pipe based on the constant values that are visible as R, small r. This small r is nothing but the constant, or you can say the resistances provided by the pipe towards the flow. If we remember the equation of Hardy cross, HF is equal to 4FL V square upon 2GD. We already derived this equation in the class. This is the equation in terms of velocity or in terms of discharge. This can be written as FL Q square upon 3D raised to 5. From this equation you can say that HF is proportional to Q square, agree? Or if you remove this proportionality, the constant that will appear in the equation is denoted by small r, where you can see in the network. This r is nothing but the combination of all these constants, that is FL upon 3D raised to 5. Or moreover, this Q square can be written apparently as inversely proportional to R. So this is very important to understand before you go for the analysis. Higher is the value of R, lesser will be the discharge to be given to the pipe. It is inversely proportional. Okay. So let's jump to the method. The name of the method is Hardy cross method. It is very popular. It is globally accepted method. There are several other methods we will be discussing in the later sessions. Now see the network. It is a closed loop. Number of pipes are 5, AB, BC, CD and AD. The very first step, or the very first thing that you need to check, is the continuity equation. What is the continuity equation? Let's remember the continuity equation as A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. You remember this equation like this. But in simple language, a continuity equation can be memorized as inflow equal to outflow. Inflow equal to outflow. Now you can see there are two inflows. There is a single inflow in the pipe at point D. The value is given as 100. No unit is given. No need to take any unit system. Just go with the values, magnitudes. There is only single point D where inflow is given in the network as 100. So 100 is the inflow, and we must check the outflow as 20 plus 50 plus 30. There are three outflow points at point A, B and C. So total of 20 plus 50 plus 30 is equal to 100. So inflow is equal to outflow. This is the very first step, or you can say it is a mandatory condition before you go for the analysis. Continuity equation must be satisfied. So we are clear with the continuity equation, right? Now let's begin with the network now. There are two loops, as you can see in the network. One loop is ACD and second loop is ABC. Before you go for the loop analysis, you need to distribute the discharges randomly. Randomly means based on your efficiency, or you can say your expertise. More you are expert in distributing the discharge based on the value of R, less number of trials you will be doing, or you'll have to do. As I could say, the method is trial and error, purely trial and error. So let's start with the discharge distribution randomly, trial 1. You should start with the inflow. If there are more number of inflows, suppose there are two number of inflows, you should start with the higher value. Okay, got it? Higher value is, here there is only single discharge, so we should start with the 100. Here at point D, there are two pipes connected, or there are two paths, P-A-T-H-S, paths possible for this inflow to go towards point A and point C. Now, how would you divide the discharge 100? You can even go for 50-50, or you can just divide by 2. But as I told, the discharge should be divided based on the values of R, that is constant. Higher is the value of R, lesser should be the discharge. Here the values are 6 and 5. Probably they are the same. Probably. So what I would do is I would divide the discharge as 50-50 only. Even you can go for the LCM, like divide by 5 and divide by 6. The total. Okay. So in CD, from point D to C, the discharge distributed is 50, and from D to A, the discharge distributed is 50. Okay. Now let's take any of one you can take. Okay. I'm taking this value 50. This 50 is going towards point A and going out as 20. I repeat, 50 is reaching at point A and total of discharge 20 is moving out. The remaining is 30. Now 30 is to be divided into AB and AC. Agree? This resembles to Kirchhoff's law, what you did in your 12th, I guess. So 50, when reaching point A, goes out as 20, and there are two paths left as AB and AC. Remember the directions, never miss out the directions. These are the two directions where we need to distribute 30, value 30 into two parts. Now you can see the values are 1 and 3. 1 means lesser value, so out of 30, higher will be the discharge towards A to B and lesser should be from A to C. So what I would do, 30 from 30, 20 I'll give from A to B and remaining 10 I'll distribute from A to C. Okay, based on the R value. Now let's take this point, 50. This 50 is reaching at point C, and again from A, discharge of 10 is coming at point C. The total of 60 is coming at point C. Total discharge arriving at point C is 50 plus 10, that is 60. And out of 60, 30 is moving out. Remaining is 30 has only one path possible from C to B. So 30 is moving from C to B. And also from A to B, 20 is moving. This 30 and this 20 combines as 50 moves out as final outflow. This is the final distribution, or you can say first trial distribution based on the our expertise. Okay, this is the tentative distribution. Now we need to analyze the loop. Now you can see there are two loops in the network. One is ACD and one is ABC. You need to take loop one by one. Let's take loop ACD trial one. Okay, now we need to assume a sign convention in the loop. As we know, there are two possibilities, clockwise or anti-clockwise. You can choose any. We are taking clockwise as positive in loop ACD. Now in the loop, you need to make a table having 5 number of columns. Column number 1 is pipe. Column number 1 is pipe. Column number 2 is R. Column number 3 is Q. Column number 4 is RQ square. And column number 5 is 2RQ. Remember this table. See, right now I'm just explaining you the procedure. Okay. The concept behind this method shall be discussed later on. Shall be in the next session. Now in loop ACD, there are 3 number of pipes, AD, DC and CA. So I'll just note it down, AD, DC and CA. The common pipe between two loops are generally noted at the last, written at the last. This is the convention. Okay. Now respective R, respective constants of these pipes are 6, 5 and 3. And the discharges that you provided on the first trial are to be noted here. we have given as 50, 50 and 10. Now RQ square and 2RQ, I have already calculated this, fortunately. So this value is 15,000. RQ square means 6 into 50 square. Accordingly, 5 into 50 square is 12,500. And this is 300. Okay, and 2RQ means 2 into 6 into 50 comes out to be 600. This is 560. Okay, now after this, the most important part arrives to check the sign or the direction of the discharges that you provided. Okay, now we have assumed clockwise as positive. Okay, so you can see in pipe AD, the direction is upward, which is causing clockwise movement in this loop. Okay, so this has to be positive. Again, in pipe DC, this is forming anti-clockwise movement in the loop. This is negative. And this 10 is causing clockwise movement. So this is positive. The most important part, only in column number 4, you need to check the sign convention. I repeat, only in column number 4, you need to check the sign convention. Rest of all the values are to be kept positive only. Let's repeat this step. What I did, this 50 is causing clockwise movement, this is causing anti-clockwise movement, and this is causing clockwise movement. So accordingly, I put positive, negative and positive in column number 4 only. Rest of all the values are to be kept positive or as it is. Okay, after this, you need to find out the algebraic sum of these two columns. Only last two columns, column number 4 and 5. This value comes out to be 2800 positive. The value could be negative, okay, but here the values comes out to be positive, and this is around 7160. After this, you need to find out delta Q, that is the ratio of sigma of RQ square upon sigma of 2RQ, means this upon this, that is 2800 positive upon 1160, and delta Q comes out to be positive as 2.413. So delta Q comes out to be positive. This could be negative depending on the signs. So this value comes out to be 2.413. Now our aim is to turn this value as 0. If delta Q comes out to be 0 in the first trial, then your analysis is complete, or your first trial is absolutely perfect. No need to go for trial 2. But the value is closer to 0 but not 0, it is 2.413. So we need to go for trial 2. Now, in the first trial, if the value is below 10, then you can say that your first trial was almost okay. It was not too randomized. It is 2.413, well below 10. So the trial was good according to me. Now, for trial 2, based on this value, you need to remember one statement. The statement is, if delta Q is positive, the value is to be subtracted from positive discharge and vice versa. I repeat, see, delta Q is positive, so we need to subtract this value from the positive discharge and add it to the negative discharge. Okay, so what were the positive discharges? 15,300. We need to add this subtract the value from these two discharges, and we'll be adding this value to the negative discharges in trial 2. Let's go for trial 2. Now for the same loop, that is loop ACD trial 2. Let me draw the loop again. Okay, A, B, C, D. The discharges that I had provided were 50, 10 and 50. Okay, these two discharges were positive, 50 and 10, and this was negative according to our first convention. Okay, so this 50, as the value delta q comes out to be positive, the delta q was delta q1, say it was positive 2.413. the value, only the value is to be subtracted from the positive discharges, and it is to be added from the to the negative discharges. This is very important. I repeat, only the value is to be added or subtracted, not along with the sign. Suppose the value would have been negative, suppose delta q1 is minus 2.413, then the only value is to be added or subtracted from the respective values or discharges. Okay, now repeat the same analysis for trial 2. Same table, pipe, R, Q, R, Q square, 2 R, Q. Everything will remain same except the value of Q. A, D, C, D, A, C, 6, 5, 3. Now, the new value for A, D is 50 minus 2.413, that is 47.58. For C, D it is 50 plus 2.413, that is 52.413, and for this it is 7.57, 10 minus 2.4. RQ square will go as 13,587. I already calculated these values, 13,735 and 172.68. The sign convention will remain same. Why? Because no values have changed their signs. For example, 50 minus 2.413 is again positive, 10 minus 2.413 is again positive, and 50 plus 2.413 is again positive. What I mean to say is, suppose delta q1 would have been 12, suppose the value would have been 12, then 10 minus 12 will go as minus 2. In that case, you need to change the direction. No need to put the sign, negative value or negative sign, but just change the direction of the discharge. Okay, as of now, we do not have any such case. So the directions have remained same. So this will be positive, this is negative, and this is positive. And accordingly, this value will be 571.04, 524.13, 22.761 sigma. Okay. So this goes as 24.68. This goes as 1117.93 positive, and delta Q2, that is for trial 2, that is again 24.68 upon 1117.93 goes out almost as 0.022, which is much closer to 0, or you can say almost 0, if you can see. So in trial 2, we got the value of delta Q as 0, and which is, I guess, more promising value as compared to trial 1. So your loop 1 or loop ABCD is completed. The same thing is to be repeated for second loop, that is loop ABC, which is to be done from your side, or it is a homework. Actually, everything is homework as of now because of the situation, but you need to solve the loop ABC and WhatsApp me your solution. You might be having my number. Okay, take from CR if you do not have. I'm talking about semester 4 civil engineering students studying at LDC, of course. WhatsApp me if you are able to solve this loop ABC, and your final answer should be in the form of network, and the final discharges are to be shown, whatever you got, whatever you get. For example, for AD I got the value as 47.58, and for CD I got 52.413. The common pipe will change. The value in common pipe will change when you go for the analysis of second loop. Okay, this should be your final solution. WhatsApp me your solution within, let's keep it 2 days, by tomorrow evening you can give me the solution. And in the next session, maybe day after tomorrow, we'll be dealing with the next topic, that is viscous flow, I guess. Please pardon in case of any inconvenience caused, because this my first attempt, and inconvenience is highly regretted. I take your leave now. Thank you. All the best.